Becky, I am one of the Active Creative team and welcome to TPAC. TPAC stands for the Performing Arts Club, and there are four elements to TPAC: drama, music, movement and arts and crafts. And every week we focus on something different. This week we're going to be focusing on space. Now I don't mean outer space with spaceships and planets and aliens, though we should do that another week, shouldn't we? When I talk about space, when we talk about space in drama or in movement, we talk about the space that's around us. This could be the space that we've got on the stage, the space that we've got in the rehearsal room, the space that we've got in the studio. For you at home, it's the space that you've got at home, okay? So in drama, we often talk about using the space. That means all of the space on the stage or the space that we've got available to use. And that's what we're going to focus on today, using some games and some warm-ups. The first game we're going to play is called Four Corners. Now you should have four corners in whatever space you're using at home. And I want you to give those corners a number. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now it doesn't matter to me what numbers they are, as long as you know what numbers you've used. I have done numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 for my corners. 1, 2, 3, 4. As long as I know which numbers they are, that's fine. So as long as you know which numbers you've put in your corners, then you can play this game. So I need you to come and stand in the middle. And what's going to happen is I'm going to shout a number and you have to run to that corner. So if I shout number one, run to your number one corner. So mine's over here. Where's your number one corner? Excellent. Come back to the middle. And then I'll shout number three. So this is my number three corner. Where's yours? Excellent. And then come back into the middle and then I'll shout number two. And you have to run to number two corner. Where's your number two corner? And back to the middle. And number four. Where's your number four corner? Mine's here. Where's your number four corner? Excellent. So in this game, we're going to wait in the middle. You're always going to have to be ready in this game because I'm going to be fast. I'm going to shout a number and you have to run to that corner. One more time, just remind yourself which corners you have numbered. 1, 2, 3, 4. Are you ready? Number 2, 4, 1, 3, 2, 4, 2. Oh, at 1, 4, 3, 2. I'm back to the middle. Excellent. Good job. It's fast, isn't it? So this time you're going to try and run to the corner and then run straight back to the middle. Okay, even faster. Ready? So you're in the middle, and we've got to go to corner 4. Back to the middle. 2, 1, 3, 4. Number 2, 3, 4. Oh no! I'm back to the middle. Number 1. Back to the middle. 3. Good job. Well done, everybody. So hopefully now you have used all of your space for that game, doing your different corners. Let's play something else. This next game is called Director on Stage. Now, you might have played lots of different versions of this game before, but this is the version that I like to play. And for my version, you need to find three different items of clothing. So three different things that you can wear. Now that can be an accessory or an actual item of clothing that you can put on. So for example, I have got some sunglasses, a jumper, and a hat. So I'm gonna give you 1 minute now. I'm gonna stop here. I'm gonna give you 1 minute to go and find three things that you can wear. Go!
Thank you.
Excellent. Have you found three things? What did you find? Excellent. Okay, so I need you to put those three things on the floor in front of you because we're going to need them for our game. Now, this is another running around game and it really helps us get used to our space, particularly our space when we're talking about being on stage, which is what our drama is all about. So when we're on stage, the audience, so we're going to pretend that the screen is your audience, okay? They would sit in the auditorium. So that would be where the audience would sit. So everything that we're doing, I want you to imagine that you are on the stage and you are looking out to the audience sitting in the auditorium, okay? You need to imagine that so that all of our directions are then correct, okay? So if you're looking at the audience there, when I say upstage, do you know which part of the stage that would be? It's right here at the back, farthest away from the audience, okay? The audience are down there, so you need to get as far away from them as you can, all the way here, upstage, okay? Then we need, if I shout downstage, you would have to come all the way down here, as close to the audience as you can go. So that way is upstage, that way is downstage. I wonder if any of you know why that's called upstage and why that's downstage. Maybe I'll leave that as a little quiz for you right now. I'll come back to that at the end. If you know, hold on to it. Excellent. If you don't know, I'll tell you at the end. So that is upstage and that is downstage. Now, as you're looking at the audience, obviously, as I'm looking at you, you've then got two different directions. You've got stage left and you've got stage right. Now, that is your left and right because you are the person on stage looking at the audience, okay? So it's your left and right. So if I said stage left, you would have to go off this way, wouldn't you? And if I said stage right, you would have to go off this way. Excellent, very, very good. So now we've got four directions. We've got upstage, downstage, stage left, and stage right. Okay, now this is a little bit like our corners game. So we're gonna do some running on the spot and I'm gonna shout one of those directions that you need to get into. Are you ready? So everybody run on the spot for me and then go stage left, stage right. Upstage, downstage, stage right, upstage, downstage, stage left. And then what do you think we'd do if I said centre stage? Exactly, we have to come right into the middle, don't we? So jog on the spot, centre stage for me, upstage, centre stage, stage right, centre stage, upstage, downstage, stage left. Centre stage. Good. And then in theatre, when we want you to stop whatever you're doing, we don't say stop, we say hold. So we're going to run wherever we're going until you hear me shout hold. If I shout hold, then you need to freeze exactly where you are and not do anything. Ready? So let's run on the spot in the middle. Stage left. Upstage. Downstage. Centre stage. Stage right. Hold. Good, good waiting. Stage left, upstage, centre stage, upstage, centre stage, upstage, centre stage, upstage, centre stage, hold. Excellent, good job. Let's do it one more time. Stage left, upstage, downstage, centre stage, hold. Excellent, good job, everybody. Right. I'm going to give you some more directions now. So now you should know your different directions on the stage. Now I'm going to give you some extra things that we have to do. When I say director on stage, do you know who the director would be? The director is someone who, if you're doing a show, the director is the person who tells you what you need to do from a drama point of view. So they would tell you where you're going to come on, where you're going to stand, how you might be feeling at that particular time, if you need to be louder, quieter. They have a very important job. They have to look over the whole show and help everybody be in the right place. So if I say director on stage, you need to pretend that you are practicing for your play. So I need you to give me a really, really dramatic pose. It can be any expression that you want, but I need the expression to be massive. Really, really over the top. Exaggerate those expressions for me. So if you're going to be afraid, I need you to be really, really afraid. If you're going to be happy, I need you to be really, really happy. And there can be a different emotion, a different expression every time the director comes on stage. But what's important is that you show your director how big you can make your expressions, okay? So we're going to add in director on stage. Then we're going to add in choreographer on stage. Does anybody know what the choreographer's job is? They are the person that makes up all of the dances that we do in shows, so in musicals or in reviews or anything like that. Any show where we have dance in it, the person that makes up those dances is called the choreographer. And so they have to come in and they watch everybody dancing and make sure they're doing it correctly. So when I shout choreographer on stage, you need to be doing your dance warm-up. Oh, that's it. Give me some good stretches. If you go to dance, maybe you can show me some of your nice dance moves that you do. So you can do any dance stretches that you want to do, but show your choreographer that you're warming up or that you're practicing your dancing. If you can do a nice pirouette, maybe try having a nice pirouette as well. So director on stage, you need to show me your expressions. Choreographer on stage, you need to show me your dance moves, your warm-ups or your dance move. And then we've got one more person, and they are called the musical director. And normally we shorten it, so we just call them the MD. That's the initials for musical director. And their job is to teach everyone all of the songs in the show that you're doing or the musical. All of the songs that you learn, the MD will teach them to you. And then they come in and they make sure that everybody is singing everything correctly. So when I say MD on stage, you have to be doing your vocal warm-up and practicing your songs. Now, we've done some vocal warm-up things already, haven't we? We've done our humming up the scale. And we've been speaking about using our diaphragm. You could do your diaphragm kicks. Ha, 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 couldn't you? So when I say MD on stage, your musical director, you need to show me that you're doing one of our singing warm-ups that we've been doing. Or you could be practicing a little bit of a song, like our True Colour song that we've done. You could be practicing a little bit of that, but you need to be singing using all of our techniques that we've been working on. So that's director on stage is your expressions, choreographer on stage is your stretches and your dance, and MD on stage is your vocal warm-up and practicing your singing. Now let's add those three into the different directions as well. So we're still doing our directions and we're doing those three instructions as well. Okay, are you ready? So jog on the spot for me. Let's go upstage. Stage left. Centre stage. Director on stage. I'm so sad. And jog on the spot. Stage right. Downstage. Upstage. Stage left. Upstage. Hold. Choreographer on stage. La 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 la. Doing some nice stretching. La 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 la. And jog. Good job. Stage right. Downstage. Stage left. Upstage. Centre stage. Upstage. Stage right. Hold. MD on stage. Hold. Good job. Run on the spot. Centre stage. And upstage. And stage left. And downstage. And centre stage. And upstage. And centre stage. And stage right. And upstage. And stage left. And centre stage. And hold. Excellent. You're doing really, really well. I am going to give you a couple more instructions just to add in for you. Now, the first one I'm going to add in is we picked these items of clothing up, didn't we? So now I'm going to tell you what we need these for. This is because sometimes I might shout, quick change! Now, a quick change in the theatre is where you have to change your costume, but you do not get very long to do it in the theatre. Anybody that's ever done a quick change will tell you that sometimes they are incredibly fast. And in this game, you don't have any time to do your quick change at all. You're going to be doing your running, and if I shout quick change, you have to grab one of these things that you can wear and go straight back to what you were doing. And then you have to keep this on until I shout quick change again. So everything that we've done, you're going to have to then do with a bit of your costume on, okay? And I might shout that at any time. And if you've already got something on, so I'll put my glasses back on again. If you've already got something on and I shout, quick change! You have to take them off and you have to put the next thing on and then come straight back and join us again, okay? So it's going to be really, really fast. So that's the first thing we're going to do. And then the other thing, and this is the last thing, I promise, last thing I'm going to add in this one, is what happens when the audience are allowed to come into the theatre. We call that, that's when the house opens, okay? So that means that the audience are now being allowed into the theatre. Now, when we're on stage, when we're in the wings, what do you think happens when we're, oh sorry, yeah, at the side of the stage, the bit where we wait, I think we have spoken about this before, the bit at the side of the stage, before you actually come onto the stage and you can be seen, the bits at the side, they are called the wings. It is super, super important that when we're in the wings, we cannot make any noise because we're still on the stage. That sound is still going to be reverberated and pushed out into the auditorium for the audience to hear us. So it's super important when we're in the wings, we shouldn't make any noise. But particularly once somebody, and it's usually the stage manager or the deputy stage manager or the assistant stage manager, one of those people will say, the house is now open. That means the audience are now in the auditorium. Cannot make any noise. It also normally means that you cannot cross the stage. Sometimes if you've got, you know, the big curtains at the front, they're called tabs. Sometimes if the tabs are closed, then the stage is still accessible, but you definitely cannot make any noise on stage or in the wings once someone has a house open. So that's what we're going to do in this one. So we might be making some noise when we're running. Oh, I'm going to get my hat. I'm going to get my hat. But as soon as I shout, house open! To stop everything you're doing and be completely silent. Good, well done. Right, so now you know all of the different rules, I think we'll just go for it. So we've got lots of rules, haven't we? Upstage, downstage, stage left, stage right, centre stage are our stage directions. Then we've got three important people to look out for, our director, our choreographer and our MD. And then we've got an extra two things now to worry about, our quick change and our house open. Excellent. Let's get started. Everybody run on the spot for me. Run, run, run. And listen out for your first stage direction. Stage left. Upstage. Downstage. Centre stage. Stage left. Stage right. Director on stage. Well done, you guys. Give yourselves a big clap. That was excellent. We have used all of our space now, haven't we? And I hope that's helped you remember all of the different directions that there are on the stage. Upstage, downstage, stage left, stage right, centre stage. Now I said, does anybody know why upstage and downstage are called those names? Some of you might know already. That's because back when theatres were first being built, we didn't have the seats called tiered seating now, where the seats all go up and up and up and up so that you can see over the person that's sitting in front of you. But we didn't used to have that when we built theatres. Most people, in fact, had to stand on the floor, or they would be sitting in rows that go up, but not like the tiered seating that we've got now. So they would actually build stages on a little slope, so the back of the stage would actually be higher up than the front of the stage. So you would literally be going up stage, like you were going up a little hill, up stage, and then downstage. Some theatres still have those, and it makes it a bit difficult when you've got scenery and things like that to put on it, because you're actually having to build the scenery on a big hill. Can you imagine how much more difficult that is trying to do a show when you've got to go up and down the hill all the time? Well done, those of you that knew that, and I hope you enjoyed that little fact if you didn't. Well done, everybody. Have you grabbed a quick drink? Because we did a lot of running around, didn't we, in that game? Excellent. The next game that we're going to do is called mirroring. Now, if you've got somebody else in your house, a brother or a sister or a grown-up, anybody that lives in your house that wants to join in this game with you, it's a brilliant game to play with a partner. But absolutely, don't worry if you haven't, you can play this game along with me. This game is called mirroring because we have to mirror each other. So whatever actions I do, you have to do them as well. Now, I might stretch up really, really high. I might go down really, really low. Whatever I do, you need to copy me. It would be great if you could get as close to me as possible, but get quite close to me so that you can see exactly what we're doing, because some of the movements will be really, really small. So it's not gonna be like dance where we're all doing really, really big things. This is about being slow and controlled and really, really copying my movements. I'm gonna put on some music and then we'll get started. So all I need you to do is copy my movements. They might be really, really small and they might be really big, but I need you to copy my movements exactly. I'm gonna start down here. So I want you to do the same. So we're crouching down here. I want you to concentrate exactly on my movements. Good job, everybody. That was really, really nice and controlled. So I hope you could really see how slowly I was doing my movements for you to copy. Now, if you can, if there's somebody else in your house that wants to play with you, then you can be the leader for them. Then they can be your mirror. So make sure that you do your moves nice and slowly. The more control you've got, the slower you do those movements, the easier it'll be for the other person to try and copy you. Okay? Well done, everybody. Great job, you guys. Have you had a quick drink? Okay, so for our last game, you're going to need one of the props that you used earlier. Doesn't matter what it is, can be something different as well, but you're going to need a prop, because what we're going to do is we're going to put the prop in one of the directions that we learned earlier. Upstage, downstage, centre stage, stage right, or stage left. So I'm going to tell you which place you're going to go and put it down into. And then you need to go and either put the prop down or pick the prop up. But I'm going to tell you how I would like you to do that, okay? So for example, I might say, I would like you to put your prop downstage and I'd like you to put it down very, very sadly. So have you got your prop? Let's do that all together. So we've got to put our props downstage, sadly. Excellent, very good, sad acting. So now our prop's already downstage, isn't it? So when I go and tell you to pick it up, you know you're going to go downstage. But this time, we're going to go and pick it up in a different way. So can you go and pick up your prop? But this time, I want you to be shy. Show me how you're going to be shy. Yeah, excellent, well done. So now you've got your prop again, so this time I'll tell you which direction you're going to put it down in and how you're going to do it. So this time, I would like you to put your prop down stage left and I would like you to do it really, really grumpy. Are you ready? Excellent. Good, grumpy acting. So now we're prop stage left, so we're going to go and pick it up. And this time, I would like you to pretend that you are really, really happy. Yeah, excellent. Good work, everybody. Right, let's do another one. I would like you to go and put your prop down stage right. And this time, I would like you to put your prop down as if you're lost. Good, lost acting, very nice. Let's do one more then all together. So we're gonna go and pick up that prop from stage right. And this time I would like you to do it as if you are a gymnast. Now some of you might be very, very good at gymnastics. I am not. So show me how you go and pick up that prop like a gymnast. Great job, well done you guys. What different ways can you think of going to pick up your props? Well done you guys, thank you for joining me for another TPAC. I'll see you all next week and you're going to need a paper plate, or if you haven't got a paper plate, if you can just get a bit of paper or a bit of card and cut it into a round circle shape, because we're going to be working on masks next week. Okay you guys, see ya!